Hey guys, Eric Merced here. In this video, I'm going to review AstroPad HQ's newest offering, which they're calling AstroPad Studio. The good folks over at AstroPad HQ reached out to me early on to review their new offering called AstroPad Studio. I want to give out a disclaimer that this video is not sponsored by AstroPad HQ, so this review is my honest, unbiased opinion. For those of you who don't know what AstroPad is, in a nutshell, AstroPad for iOS and Mac OS X transforms your iPad Pro into a Wacom Cintiq-like tablet with the ability to use your Apple Pencil on your favorite desktop apps like Photoshop, Clip Studio Paint, and much more, with the added benefits that the Apple Pencil already brings with the iPad Pro over Cintiq tablets. AstroPad is one of the reasons why I decided to upgrade to an iPad Pro instead of a Surface Pro, and ever since I've had zero use for my Cintiq. If you're looking for a good review of AstroPad, check out my buddy Brad Colbo's awesome review of AstroPad. I've left the link in the video description below. Being a big fan of AstroPad, I couldn't pass up the opportunity to test out and review AstroPad HQ's newest offering. So exactly what is AstroPad Studio, and how is it different from the standard AstroPad app? You can pretty much say AstroPad Studio is exactly like the standard AstroPad app, but on steroids. The developers of the app are marketing the app as a step up from their standard app, targeted towards pro users looking for more flexibility and options. If the standard AstroPad app blew your mind with its almost magical ability to transform your iPad Pro into a Cintiq, then AstroPad Studio is going to probably wow you beyond belief. So let me make this clear. The app is not perfect, but it's sure damn good at what it does and definitely worth upgrade from the standard app. Let's talk features. One of the biggest differences between the standard and studio app is the UI. Where the standard app sports a lighter, simpler UI, the studio version sports a darker UI with a lot of more options. Both retain the ability to invoke the sidebar with a tap of the menu ring, which you can move around, but you'll soon see that the studio has a lot of more options tucked away in this menu bar. Chief among these new additions is a new feature called Workspace. This feature gives you the ability to add custom shortcuts to the sidebar on a per application basis. Also new is the ability to change the line preview color for your strokes, as well as another new feature which AstroPad HQ is calling Magic Gestures. With Magic Gestures, you can, for example, tap and hold on the screen with two fingers and then touch with the tip of the Apple Pencil to bring up a contextual menu. Another magic stroke allows you to quickly switch from the current brush you're using to an eraser, and they're customizable too. Finally, keyboard support has also been added to the Studio app. The final thing I want to talk about is performance, because what use are all these new exciting features if the app doesn't perform well, right? Well, AstroPad Studio feels faster than the standard app. In my test of the app, I never once had it crash on me. Neither the Mac OS X app or the iOS app. And while pixelation is apparent in the standard app when moving the canvas around or zooming in or out, it's not completely gone in the studio version, but it's a whole lot less noticeable now, especially when you're using a tethered connection. For those of you thinking that AstroPad Standard will soon disappear, replaced by Studio, fear not. AstroPad HQ realizes that the studio version of their app is not for everyone, so they plan on continual development of the standard app. With Studio, however, they are targeting pro users who will want more features when using apps like Photoshop or Clip Studio Paint on the desktop. As of this review, the standard app will be available on the App Store for the current set price. However, with Studio, AstroPad HQ has decided to join Adobe in the subscription model they began with their apps by making AstroPad Studio available for a monthly or yearly rate. Monthly, AstroPad Studio will cost you $7.99. while the yearly option will set you back $64.99. As of this review, the standard app remains at $29.99, with both Mac OS apps remaining free. So is AstroPad Studio worth the hype and heavier price tag? If your usage of the app is minimal, then no. You're better off sticking with the standard version, which is great. However, if you already use AstroPad Standard on an everyday basis and wish it could do a bit more than what it currently does, then I can't recommend Studio enough. I've been using it for the entirety of this review, on and off, and I'm definitely going to be looking into getting a subscription myself. I hope you've enjoyed this review. If you did, please consider giving it a thumbs up to show your support. And as always, you can subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Until then, I'll see you all in the next video. Stay creative and create great things. God bless.